Hallelujah. Bwana Yesu asifiwe sana. Praise the Lord. Thank you very much for joining us yet again. I know the Lord has been with you all along since we were together again. Glory be to his holy and perfect name. Before we get to the service this day, I acknowledge that it is a Father's Day. And I take this opportunity to wish every father Happy Father's Day. Happy Father's Day from the depth of my heart. And even from the Teaching Transformation Ministry, I bring you Father's Day blessings and greetings. Praise the Lord. I want to acknowledge that indeed everyone who is born on the face of the earth is a seed that is given through a father. So fathers are critical in our lives. So glory to the Almighty God for giving us a father. So God bless you so much for being responsible father, physical, biological or even a spiritual in the matters of faith. I just want to say Happy Father's Day. I recognize you. I salute you. Thank you very much. At this point, I want us to get to the service of today with thankfulness because it's a day the Lord has made. We're gonna be glad and rejoice in this day. Apologies that we got a bit late with our connection, but it is well the Lord is with us. The message shall surely come forth because God is never late. Praise be to the Almighty God. I know you've continued to be blessed, so sit still and enjoy the blessings of the living God. Your expectation shall not be cut off. I'm sure you are expectant of God's blessing. It will not be cut off at this point. Amen. Glory to God. Let us just commit the service to God as we pray together, giving him thanks and all praise. He deserves all the glory and all the honor. Amen. Let us pray. Heavenly Father, in the name of Jesus Christ, we bow with thankfulness before your presence. We are so grateful, Lord, for this day. That, dear Lord, you are our Father, loving Father. Before anyone ever became a father, you are. And so, Lord, we appreciate you as a loving Father. We are so grateful to know the love of a Father, the care of a loving God. We know you, Lord, because you are indeed faithful in our lives. You introduced yourself to us. You revealed yourself to us. And we are grateful to be called sons and daughters of the Almighty God, the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords. This hour, dear Lord, we submit in honor and with a sacrifice of praise, with a worship before you. We adore you. We exalt you, Lord. Hallowed be your holy name. You deserve all the glory, great God, Yahweh. You deserve all honor and all adoration. Let all the praise, my Father, be forever unto you, Lord. As we assemble this day, dear Lord, in worship to you, Lord, fellowshipping, my Father, in your presence, we thank you that you are with us. This service, dear Lord, is given over to you, for it's all about you, Almighty God. You are the center of our gathering, even through this online service. And thank you for every listener, Upper Father, because, Lord, they shall be blessed. Each one shall carry loads of blessings, even as you minister to us. So, Lord, we are submitting to the Spirit of the living God that you have your way and bring praise to yourself. This is our submission to you with thanksgiving and with honor in Jesus' mighty name. Amen. Praise the Lord. Yet again, I'm here to talk to us as the Lord led us that I may speak to us. Dear Father has given us a very powerful word, and I'm ever grateful that every moment that we gather, he speaks to us. So even now, there is a word that the Lord has put in my spirit, and it is about pillars of sustenance. Praise the Lord. Tell yourself, I know I appeal us to keep me continually sustained at the position of dominion. Amen. They are those pillars that the Father has given so that we remain sustained at the position of dominion. Amen. The message of dominion has not ceased to be spoken by the Father. There must be something that the Lord wants us to grasp, run with. Amen. And we become as the word is. Praise the Lord. Last Sunday, we still talked about dominion. A number of Sundays before, we still talked about dominion. So praise be to the Lord. If you missed, you are not joined in, it is okay to just check at the Teaching Transformation Ministry Facebook. It is recorded right there, message of dominion. Because I know the Father wants us to take up dominion. And as we are getting to prepare ourselves for the return to worshiping in the areas of sanctuary, I know we've been worshiping at home, praising the Lord at home, exhorting Him and reading His word at home. We have raised altars in our own homes. Now, as we are preparing for the Lord to unlock us, or rather to open for us, that we may gather together even physically with one and another, fellowshipping one and another in our place of worship, I know the Father wants us to return as a church that is at the position of dominion. Amen. And that's why He is not over with us, over the message of dominion. Bwana asifiwe sana. So today we are looking at pillars of sustenance. At where? At our position, at the place of dominion. Bwana Yesu asifiwe sana. Let me submit to us that Jesus Christ is coming soon. I say again, Jesus Christ is coming soon. This one you can read at your own time on Ephesians chapter 5 and verse 27. He is not coming for a church that is weakling. He is not coming for a defeated church. He is coming back for a victorious and glorious church. Amen. And because Jesus Christ is coming back for a victorious church, He is coming back for a body of Christ that is strong, that is moving forth with the glory of the living God. I want to submit to us, this is why the Spirit of the Lord is emphasizing on us remaining at the point of dominion. Amen. Position of our dominion without falling down. Amen. I am sure you have ever seen people, or you have an experience of rising up. You remain a little up there, then you calm down. You have maybe seen others, they rise up, they calm down. You may have heard of a book that was written, The Rise and Fall of Idi Amin. You know, the risk of rising and falling, the end result might be a fall. Because Idi Amin, the story ends with a fall. So the risk of being a child of God who is on rise and fall without sustenance, the risk is that you may be found at the point of fall. That is why the Father is so gracious today to give us a message of pillars of sustaining us at the position of dominion. Where He has lifted us, the Father would want us to be continually sustained at the position of dominion. Glory to the living God. And this morning I want to pray that our hearts will embrace the aspect and the power to sustain, to be sustained by the Spirit of God, continually moving higher and higher and higher and higher. Bwana Yesu asifiwe sana. Glory to the Almighty God. I know wherever you are, you can hear me. One thing I know is that the desire of our God is that we are lifted from one glory to another. Bwana Yesu asifiwe sana. And so the matter of rising and then straight away the history is gone, you can never be heard any longer. It is not the will of the Father that one time we are up there with much glory on spiritual matter, speaking the word of God, ministering to the people, and they are getting born again, and we are there praying all night or even all day. We are there reading the word. We are there worshiping the Lord. Then shortly after, one is found down here. No, it is about being sustained at that position of dominion. Hallelujah. Let me submit to us. Besides having pillars of sustenance, the Lord would also want people to be holistic in nature, such that when He is lifting us up, when He has caused us to take up the position of dominion, it is not only in one aspect, I repeat, it is not only in one aspect, it is holistic. The Father delights when we are whole. Amen. Praise God. I know you know when the leper came back to tell Jesus, thank you for healing him from leprosy. You know when he had sent him to show himself to the priest. Jesus told him, you are not only healed, but you are whole. What does that therefore mean? The Father wants every one of us to be upheld at a position of dominion with an aspect of wholeness. I repeat, an aspect of wholeness. And so today, we are going to look and we are looking at pillars of sustenance at the position where the Father allows us to have holistic kind of well-being, where our dominion, when we are up there, we are whole spiritually. We are alert spiritually. We are hearing what the Father is saying. At the same time, we can be able to communicate and be ambassadors of the kingdom of God and tell others about Jesus. We can make others come to know Jesus. That is being holistic spiritually. And that your spiritual stand is not determined on anything that goes well or doesn't go well. In a moment, you can praise the Lord in and out of season. Bwana asifiwe sana. So our position of being sustained by the Spirit of the Lord at that level of dominion spiritually means, therefore, that our walk with the Lord is not determined by circumstances. It is a relationship. Bwana asifiwe sana. Amen. I hope you agree with me on this. Again, I'm here to submit to us. The Father desires that economically we come out, we take up the position of dominion. And when we take up that position of dominion, we continue moving from one level to another, having impact even financially to the kingdom of God. Amen. The Father wants even socially we be a people who can have meaningful relationship. And these relationships are impacting at the family level, church level, and in the nation. Why? The Father wants that holistic aspect. Even in your physical well-being, the Father is concerned and he wants us to be to take the position of dominion when we are war, even physically. Amen. That we glorify him with the bones that are strong, with a voice that can glorify and praise him. So we are taking a position of dominion when we are aware that all these aspects are at lifted level and they are sustained. Glory to the living God. I'm talking about pillars of sustenance. And what is it that is being sustained? The position of dominion. At what level? When we are holistic, where when physically, spiritually, socially, economically, mentally, we are a people that are already have taken their position of dominion. Bwana Yesu asifiwe sana. This is what I wanted to put across as an introduction for this message, that the pillars of sustenance. Amen. Pillars of sustenance. Hallelujah. Kwa wale wote wanaonisikiza, let me speak a bit of Kiswahili. Wale wote wanaonisikiza na wanaelewa Kiswahili, ningetaka niseme kwa kifupi sababu mambo ya Kiswahili mnajua ni kuaminia na aminia Mungu kila wakati, hata kizungu niseme kwa ukweli. But wacha niwaambie wapendwa, wakati umefika ili tuwe na vikingi zenye zimetushikilia katika ile mahali ya mamlaka Mungu ametuinua. Amen. Na Mungu anataka hiyo pahali pa mamlaka, mahali ametuinua, tuwe watu wenye wamechukua hiyo mamlaka na tunaendelea katika umamlaka. Sio leo kuwa tumeinuka na kesho atupatikani. Leo tunaomba sana, kesho atuombi. Leo tunaimba sana, kesho atuimbi. Hapana. Wokovu wetu na mwenendo wetu ndani ya Kristo inafaa iendelee kutoka Januari hadi Disemba, mwaka nenda na mwaka rudi, kutoka kiwango moja ya utukufu hadi ni nyingine. Asifiwe Bwana Yesu. Mungu hataki ati wakati mmoja uwe umeinuka sana na wakati mwingine kama kesho uko chini sana. Baba leo anatufunza ya kwamba kunayo ile pira ama vikingi zinazotushikilia ili tukaweza kukamilisha mapenzi yake Mungu, tukiwa na nguvu, tukiwa katika pahali pa mamlaka na bila kuanguka chini. Kwa hivyo leo tunashikilia hii neno ya kuamua ya kwamba tunayo hizo vikingi zenye zitatushikilia mpaka mwisho. Bwana Yesu asifiwe sana. Najua unaelewa kizungu, kwa hivyo wacha niende tena kwa kizungu. Nilikuwa tu nataka kukupatia hiyo mwanzo tu, introduction, ndio usimiss hata kidogo. Bwana asifiwe sana. Amen. We are going on with the word of the living God. It's exciting to get back to where we started. We started from Genesis chapter 1 and I want us to go there yet again. Genesis chapter chapter 1, we cannot talk of dominion without referring to the origin of dominion. And I said this position of dominion was restored back through death and resurrection of Christ Jesus. So Genesis chapter 1, verse 26 until verse 28 is where we are looking at. Bwana asifiwe sana. Genesis chapter 1, verse 26, and we are looking up to verse 28. Amen. I know you are there in Jesus' name. The Bible says, and God said, let us make man in our image. Are you there? After our likeness, let them have dominion. Say dominion. And today we are saying, we have the pillars of dominion. Glory to the Almighty God. We have the pillars of dominion. Glory to the living God. Let them have dominion over the fish of the sea, over the fowl of the air, and over the cattle, and over the earth, all the earth, actually all the earth, and over every creeping thing that creepeth upon the earth. Verse 27. So God created man in his own image, in the image of God, created him, male and female, created he, them, amen. So none has an excuse, whether male or female. The last verse, and God blessed them, amen. Today I want someone to confess and say, I am blessed of God, amen. Say it right there, I am blessed of God. God already blessed us, amen. And God blessed them. Praise be to the Lord. God blessed them. And what did he do? He said something to them. This is the position of dominion that nobody should miss on. Amen. And he said, hallelujah. Be fruitful and multiply. Amen. Say, I am blessed to be fruitful and to multiply. I am blessed to replenish the earth and to subdue it. I am blessed to take dominion in Jesus' name. The Bible says very clearly, and God blessed them, and God said unto them, be blessed, be fruitful, sorry, and multiply, and replenish the earth, and subdue it, and have dominion over the fish of the sea, and over the fowl of the air, and over every living thing that moveth upon the earth. Bwana Yesu asifiwe sana. When God spoke about blessing man, and he said that we be fruitful, multiply, replenish the earth, subdue it, and have dominion over the fish of the sea, fowl of the air, and over every living thing that moveth upon the earth. What did God mean? Hallelujah. It is nothing to do with something temporary. I say it is permanent dominion. Amen. Continuous dominion, continuous, praise the Lord, being continuous in being fruitful, being continuous in multiplying. You know, when I say being continually fruitful, Psalm verse 1, if you look at your own time, not necessarily now, it says for sure, we will be like a tree planted by the riverside that bears fruit all year round. When asked if you are a son, what does that tell you? I can be fruitful or in January, February, counted until December, all year round. Amen. So the will of my Father is that for one, I should be somebody who enjoys fruitfulness continually. Bwana asifiwe sana. And it's a time that Pastor Jim also talked to us about fruitfulness, being fruitful all season. Bwana asifiwe sana. So when God says that he has given us dominion, it wasn't to be temporary. It wasn't to be rise and fall. No, it was rise and continue being fruitful. Take your position of dominion and continue being fruitful. Take your position of dominion, continue multiplying. Take your position of dominion, continue replenishing the earth. Take the position of dominion and continue subduing the earth. Bwana asifiwe sana. What the Spirit of the Lord is talking to us today, that as a church, that the Lord has also given an opportunity to be prepared while we are having altars in our own home. We have been at that moment of having self-reflection, of saying, who am I? You know, congregation, who am I with my God? And whoever you have defined yourself to be with your God, the Lord would want that relationship to produce fruitfulness, to make sure you are multiplying good fruits. You know, you are fruitful, you are multiplying, you are subduing the heart, you know, and you are taking dominion. Bwana asifiwe sana. And the Father does not want temporary positioning. He wants us to be on a dominion that is continuous. Bwana asifiwe sana. A time comes that every moment we must remind ourselves that we have taken dominion. And the dominion that we have taken, the desire of our Father. What the Father wants with us is every moment that He looks at us, He is exalted. He is glorified. There is no time that He regrets that He ever made you His child. Hey, praise the Lord. Because the moment you are fruitful continually, you are multiplying continually, you are subduing continually, you are taking dominion continually, I can tell you, the Father in heaven rejoices that He is finding delight even because of your faith. Bwana asifiwe sana. So it's our point today to be careful to take the pillars that will keep us sustained at the position of dominion. Glory to the Almighty God. I said earlier that in 2 Corinthians, I think it is in chapter 3, 17 to 18, that God wants us to be from one level of glory to another. Not one point we are up, another point there is no glory. My friend, the longer time you spend with God, the longer you stay with your God, the more the glory. Amen. So continue and continue and continue that you may continue to enjoy dominion from that position of the relationship with God. Amen. Because if you spend more time praising Him, praying, reading His word, you have more glory. And I can tell you of a truth. It is even evident physically. You can be able to distinguish someone who has been with the Lord. And I see this confidently because even when Moses went and spent so long time with God, when he came back from the mountain, the children of Israel were saying, oh my goodness, look at how he looks, you know. It was evident he had spent time with God 40 days and 40 nights. Amen. When Jesus was with the disciples at the mountain and there was transfiguration, there was so much glory of the living God. My friend, the longer time you spend with the Lord, the more you continually enjoy His glory and you move from one level of glory to another. These are some of the directions to what we are going to as pillars of sustenance. Amen. Because you cannot talk about being sustained by the Lord at the position of dominion and yet you don't spend time with the giver of dominion. Amen. He is the giver and the source of dominion. So for us to succeed in having the rightful dominion over the waters, all the waters, whether fish or whatever, if He gave me dominion over the fish and it's most valuable from the water, then every other thing over the water, I have dominion over it. He told me over the earth, all the earth. He told me over the air. Come on, my friends. It is time to remain at the position that the Father wants us to take. Amen. I know after this service, and I know very well, even as we prepare to get back to the place where we are meeting together, physically with one another, I know and I'm 100% convinced that the Father will give somebody who is listening this message and believing it an instruction to take a position that you never thought you could take. Amen. And this is position of dominion. Whether in the church circles where you find yourself ministering in an area that you never knew about, it's because the Spirit of the Lord leads us even to the unfamiliar paths. The Lord might instruct you or cause you to start serving Him in an area that has never been familiar to you. This is taking the position of dominion. You may find when people are taking leadership position in whatever circle, you may find yourself there. Others will find themselves in new job. Amen. There are others who will find themselves even in new businesses. Why? It is because we have entered the position of dominion. Amen? And why are we at this point? Because Jesus is preparing us for His return. And as I said at the beginning, He is not coming for a weakling church. He is coming for a very glorious, powerful body of Christ. The bride must be fully prepared in all manner that when we are meeting Him in the air, we are not in regret saying, oh my, you have finally come. We were about to die. No, we'll be saying, thank you, you have come. We praise you and meet you in the air with rejoicing, a victorious, glorious church. Bwana Yesu asifiwe sana. Amen. we are saying that we must continually remain at the position of dominion without coming down. Amen. You know, one of the ministers who speaks so often in my life told me another day that I must learn to always say, I am on the top of the mountain. I've refused to come down. And that is it. I have taken dominion and refused to come down. Amen. It must be continuous. Bwana asifiwe. I know it has sung that the dominion the Father is giving us is not short term. Amen. It is continuous. Amen. Glory to the living God. When you know that every day, you'll be rising up and saying, Father, thank you for another day to portray the dominion that you have given me. Thank you, Father, for you give me a chance to glorify you with the position of dominion that you have granted to me. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. May the Lord help us. May the Lord help our hearts that every moment that we are on the face of the earth, we will remember that we were lifted up by God from the lowest of the lowest, that we take position of dominion. Glory to the Almighty God. Church, I'm reminding us for us to continually remain at the position of dominion. Then it is that life that we must take up. We take up a life where we know we are founded on a rock that can never, it can never be shaken. Praise be to God. You know, like Matthew 7:24-25, maybe we can read there because it's an issue of foundation, because where you are founded will determine how far you will go. Praise be to the Lord. And so if we are saying that you are taking up the position of your dominion, understand where, what your foundation is. It is going to determine how far you will go. Bwana asifiwe sana. And as Jesus was teaching through parable, he said, therefore, whosoever heareth these sayings of mine and doeth them, I will liken him unto a wise man which built his house upon a rock. The Bible continues to say in verse 25, and the rain descended, and the floods came, and the winds blew and beat upon that house. Are you with me? And it fell not, for it was founded upon a rock. It's a parable that carries so many lessons. But the thing that I want us to pick before I look at the five pillars of sustenance that the Lord told me to talk about, and I know you are able to look at others. What I want us to start understanding is that everybody will take up position of dominion and remain sustained. You must be careful of your foundation. If you are rightly founded on Christ Jesus, I repeat, if you are rightly founded on Christ Jesus, then you can be assured to be built on and on and on without any moment of falling down. Because the rock at which you are founded on can never be shaken by floods, can never be shaken by the wind, can never be shaken by rain. Amen? Why? Because when you understand your position of dominion, it is not by power, not by might, but by the Spirit of God. It is about the faith that you have in Christ that has picked you to the position of dominion. Then you will never imagine of falling, and you can never fail. Bwana asifiwe sana. So I'm at a point where I want us to understand something. That a time has come that you must know one more time there is going to be a distinction between those who serve God, those who love him, those who are founded on Christ, and those that are not. Because if you are founded on the rock Christ Jesus, you are like the house that is firmly built. Whatever comes, it will never shake you. I'm not saying that when you take position of dominion, there will never be challenges. There will be. The rain will come. The wind will come. You know, the waters will come. But the truth of the matter is, you will remain firm and you will be moving from one level of glory to another. Bwana asifiwe sana. Why? Because you are like a house that has been built on the rock. The reason being, you have the word of the Lord in you. That which built you or founded you on what you are, what your dominion is. That word of the Lord. Bwana asifiwe sana. I know you are with me. I know the Lord is speaking to our hearts. That a time has come that the position of our dominion, you know, starts entirely on the foundation of Christ Jesus. If there is any other foundation, my friend, that will come down. It will be like rise and fall. But if the foundation is on Christ Jesus, then you are set to go. You are good to go. Keep on going, brother. Keep on going, sister. There is greatness and you will never come down. You will go continually to the very end, to the glory and honor of our God. Till Jesus comes back again. You will continue to praise him, to please him, to accomplish his purpose on the face of the earth. Hallelujah. Glory to God. If I were you, I would say right now, I know I have pillars to sustain me to my position of dominion. I have the pillar because first and foremost, I'm founded on the rock Christ Jesus. And this rock can never be shaken, can never be shaken whatsoever. Amen. Can I give you the few pillars that the Lord was speaking to me? And I know as you study the word, as you listen to the Spirit of the Lord, he will continue to speak to you more and more, more and more of these pillars that sustain a child of God, a son and a daughter in the kingdom, on the position that the Father wants you to take without coming down. Amen. So that ever in your life it shall be written of you that indeed this one held on to the very end. Praise be to the Lord. Amen and amen and amen. Glory to God. The first pillar that I would want us to be cautious about. I identify what picked you up to your level of dominion. Identify who picked you up to the level of dominion. Amen. Identify and respect. Identify and respect what picked you to the position of dominion. Who picked you to the position of dominion? Hey, what am I saying? My friends, there are times that the Lord will cause, you know, you to go through a situation so that you discover the position of your dominion. And if you want to be somebody who remains at the position of sustained dominion such that you're not coming down, respect what God uses to keep you up at the position of dominion. Hallelujah. I know we could count of so many reasons or factors that kept us up, or rather lifted us up to the position of dominion. I quote a few. Perhaps you spent a moment and again praying and fasting, or praying with fasting. And you prayed and prayed, sought the Lord. He came through for you, picked you up, positioned you at your position of dominion. Maybe at the same time, you met with a prophet while you're still in prayer and fasting, who spoke a word in your life. And when they spoke a word in your life, you find yourself lifted at the position of your dominion. Perhaps it could be that you kept confessing and declaring, this position is mine. Maybe all the three worked out for you. Praise God. And if all the three were working for you, perhaps that is where you found yourself. I'm identifying and I'm respecting whatever lifted me up. I repeat again. Perhaps you found yourself praying with fasting and you're saying, Father, I refuse to be in an ordinary position. I choose to take up my dominion position, the position of my dominion, either at workplace or even in the church, in the work of the Lord, or whatever circle, even in your business. And right there you are broken through, or you are breaking through, or you are on a journey of breaking through because you chose to take up praying, fasting, maybe believing in what a true prophet spoke in your life, you know. Maybe you kept confessing, all these were working for you. And you find yourself right there at the position of dominion. My friend, wherever you will go, whatever you will do in your life, do you want to be sustained at the position of dominion? Respect that which God used to pick you up at that level. I give my own life example. When I was, I said a while ago that I used to be a high school teacher. A time came and the Lord chose to take me to the Ministry of Education in the government. Life was so good. And I was moving on well with a good job in the government. While I was still there, I came across one man that I also sought permission to talk about him today. And he was okay with that. Professor Kabiro Kinyajui, a renowned educationist in the country. I met him one time. We were in a workshop somewhere in Mombasa. One of the evening, we sat like this. He looked at me and he said, you know what? You're going very far. The Lord is taking you to another dimension. And you see yourself rise to highest heights than you have ever imagined. me. I did not know so much about the faith of Professor Kabiru Kinyajui. It's recently that I got to know he's a God-fearing man. But all along, I regarded him as a professional mentor in the matters of education and peace programs. And we went on. It did not end even a year from the time that he spoke that word. I found myself in another job. You know, I found myself being an associate director in World Vision. I'm saying this to you to tell you something. Just walk with me. Thereafter, World Vision, I met him again when there was a bit of reorganization in World Vision, and there was a risk of even losing my position. And so I met him to tell him that I'm thinking of picking a certain other job. It didn't look really very stable, but I was telling him, because of this, I may have to take this other opportunity. He said, no, the Lord will keep you safe. You know, he just said that. And for sure, the Lord kept me safe in World Vision. When time came for me to finish my stay in World Vision, I don't know how I still met him again. You know, there are those friends that you can stay for a year, then you meet again, or even 2 years. Then we met again. He said, the Lord is about to lift you again. And that is when the Lord picked me up. And I'm saying this to the glory of God, just to share an example. That is the Lord, when the Lord picked me up again from World Vision, made me a country director of Build Africa. While I stayed there, there were so many issues, but the Lord did his assignment in Build Africa. Shortly after, I met him again. And he said, you know what? The Lord is taking you to another high level. And the Lord used him to speak to me over the position I am at today. So I'm saying this with all humility, but to make us understand that there are those people, there are those events that the Lord will use to pick you up. And if you want to be sustained and to the position of your dominion, may you identify and respect what God uses to boost you and to take you from one level to another. Because it's very clear that there is a voice that speaks into my life. I do not say that there are others who don't speak. I know there are many people who have been speaking in my life, but I sought permission from Professor Kabiru Kinyajui just to mention to us this. I regard this man. I respect him. Why? Because he now understands his prophetic position in my life. He doesn't even have a title of a prophet. He is professor and he is a renowned educationist. But look, because his heart means well and the Lord uses him to see, you know, where God is taking me professionally. The Lord uses him as a voice. That's why I'm saying, identify what God uses to keep you, to what God used to put you at the position of dominion, because he shall for sure move to use the same. Amen. Are you getting me, friends? I'm here to understand, to help us understand the pillars that sustain us to the position of dominion. Glory to God. I'm not saying that I worship him, but I salute and I respect him. Amen. So I'm not saying we worship men, you know, whom we are walking with on the earth, but the Lord uses people. God loves people. He uses people in whichever manner to fulfill his purpose. Glory to the living God. A time has come, friends, that you identify in your economical position, in your spiritual positioning, who is it that the Lord uses? I sound a warning here, friends, that there are people that God gives grace and he says, you'll be blessed under this grace. Respect that grace. It is what God will use as a pillar for you to be sustained to where you are going. I have seen some people that the Lord brought my way when they did not have anything. And I'm here to say with all humility, the Lord caused me to pray with them. But when they went up and up, they decided to do something we used to say in my rural village. Siki, kurusha siki. You know, yo kusema, it doesn't really matter. And when they continued with that attitude, the Lord himself knows these people are not respecting the grace that the Lord used in their lives. I'm here to announce to us, my friends, can we be very, very careful, very, very careful to honor, to respect what God uses to take us up. Amen. Because whatever God used to take you up is what will sustain you to the very end. Hallelujah. At the point is hung, if it has, then my friend, identify and respect what God used to take you up to your position of dominion. Because he will use the same to sustain you to the next level of your dominion. Hallelujah. Glory to God. You know, at your own time, you could look at Galatians 2:21. Which says, do not frustrate the grace that the Lord releases upon your life. Don't frustrate that grace. That grace is so powerful. It's not about a person. It's grace that the Lord uses to take you to the next level. So that is the grace that the Lord will help you to identify, to respect, and not to frustrate. Glory to the Almighty God. Chapter 3 of the same verse 7 to 9, it just continued to say, we are blessed because Abraham, our father, was also blessed. Glory to the Almighty God. I'm saying this, friends, we should not frustrate that grace that was in Abraham because we are of the Abrahamic covenant. So we cannot kick, you know, give a kick unto what God used to bless us. We have regard to Father Abraham, not that we worship him, but we regard him as a father of faith, you know. Praise the Lord. So I'm here to say this, that if you want to be sustained at your position of dominion, mark this and don't forget. I know you are already on the rightful foundation of Christ Jesus. Hallelujah. Then learn, therefore, to identify whatever. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. To identify whatever pillar the Lord has taught you today. That is one of the key pillars. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Basi ninataka niseme hivi wapendwa. Wale wanao nisikiza. Kama unataka kuendelea katika mahali pako pa umamlaka, basi kunazo nguzo Mungu anazotumia ama pillars. Kuna nguzo sio Mungu anazotumia ili ukaendelee kukaa katika pahali pako pa utawala. Na moja ya hizo nguzo niyo nimesema kwa Kiswahili. Nimesema hivi, tambua na uamue na uangalie ni nguzo gani Mungu aliyotumia kukuinua katika pahali pako pa utawala. Basi mahali pale alipotumia, ile alipotumia, kama ni mtu aliyotumia ili ukaweze kuinuka, basi heshimu yoyote Mungu aliyotumia. Bwana apewe utukufu. Heshimu ile neema iko katika pahali upoinuliwa. Hiyo ndio itakusaidia kukaa katika mahali pako pa utawala. Bwana asifiwe sana. Number 2, because of time I may not go to the details, but I am sure you have gotten something, you know. I said maybe God used a moment when you prayed, fasted a lot, you spoke the word of God over and over again, or someone spoke in your life, you know, or you gave even a rough offering, you know. If you are to climb and to be sustained to the next level, my friend, remember what God used. Remember who God used, because that's where your key of your grace is. Amen. To be sustained to the next level. Hallelujah. Very quickly to the next point. Remain attached to the vine as a branch is always to the vine and bears fruit. Amen. We are a branch, you know. Our Lord Jesus Christ is the vine. And we are the branches. Amen. John chapter 15, 4 to 5. You know, do you want to bear fruit continually? Do you want to bear fruit of your dominion continually? Spiritually, socially, economically, physically, whatever. Praise the Lord. Mentally. Do you want the fruits to continue bearing those nice fruit, sweet fruits, fruit of the Holy Spirit, praise the Lord? Then understand, you can never bear fruits away from Jesus Christ. Amen. 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 You can never then have continuous dominion, position of dominion away from Christ. In the moment that one will start thinking, there is another option. That is the moment they start coming down. So we'll be saying the rise and fall. What caused the fall? It was not anything else but the fact that one got away, you know, from the source. And that is the vine, Jesus Christ. Praise the Lord. When you remain in Christ, His word remains in us. Then you continually remain at the position of dominion. You bear fruit to the very end. Here round, here come, here go. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. At that point, amen. I know you are writing. I know you do know how to carry a notebook and a pen. Amen. At that point, trust God always. Trust Jesus. 'Tis so sweet to trust in Jesus. Trust in God. Amen. Trust in God. Do not lean on your understanding. Proverbs chapter 3, 5 to 6. Trust in the Lord. If you trust in God always, my friend, every point you find yourself continually remaining a at the position of dominion, and you never come down. Why? I'm trusting on him who never fails. I'm trusting on him who is unshaken. Amen. I'll be, like a tree that bears fruit always. Why? I'm trusting on him, the source of my fruitfulness. Praise be to the Lord. Amen. Don't be like this man who was seated at the pool, waiting for a man. You know, I'm waiting for a man. When Jesus asked him, do you want to be healed? Do you want dominion in your health? He started to say, I've been waiting for a man to throw me in the water. Don't wait for a man. Don't wait for a toilet. Amen. You can read that in John 5, 6 to 7. Don't wait for a man. Wait for Jesus, because the moment Jesus came into the scenario, he came and gave a word difference to the man who was there 38 years. Amen. You can remain at the position of stagnation without growing in the position of dominion by just trusting on men, waiting for a person to promote you. But when you trust in God and not look at a person, just waiting on the Lord. Amen. Then the Lord will make a difference in your life. Say amen. Hallelujah. I said there were five points. I don't know whether I'll be able to finish the rest in the short moment that is remaining. But if you want to be a person who is going to enjoy dominion of your position, the position of your dominion continually, then trust in the Lord. Trust in the Lord. Are you there? I hope we are at the fourth point now. The fourth point. Hallelujah. Woo! This one is a great one, and I'll never cease to mention this. Humility. 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 True humility. True humility. You have never seen a person who gets money. Hey, talk to a man who has money, or even a woman anyway, for that matter. Hey, talk to a man who has power and does not have Christ, my father. Hey, they have such an elated kind of a false ego, you know, that makes them think it's by their might they found themselves there, you know. And that's when they stop remembering the Lord who took them up there. And you know, that's what God caused Saul to come down. Because he was so proud, so much believing on himself, he couldn't even wait for Samuel to come and sacrifice. So I'm here speaking to us. Do you want to continually remain at the position of your dominion? Basi, 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 uphold humility. Amen. Philippians 2, 8 to 9. Philippians chapter 2, 8 to 9. Jesus thought he was God. He humbled himself low to come for us. And by that humility, the Lord himself gave him a name that's above every other name. Amen. Your humility will keep you continually at the position of your dominion. Amen. I do not have time to emphasize so much on that. But my friend, even if you are praying for everything and it's coming to be, remember, it is not by the hand of a man. It is by the power of the living God. Even if your revelation is deeper than I don't know what, please remember, it's the Spirit of the Lord. He is the one giving the revelation. Even if whatever, even if you have billions and trillions, remember, the giver of all things is the Father in heaven. Amen. That you dare never be proud. Never ever think it's by our might. I do not have so much to talk about this. But I'll say, James 4:10, the Bible says, humble yourselves in the eyes of the Lord. He will lift you up. Hallelujah. Do you want to remain lifted up? Humble yourself in the sight of God. And it's not that kind of humility. When I was young, we were told for us to go to church, it's like we are making God get shocked. We were to go slowly, and we were not to tap on our feet so that we don't make noise, you know. And that was counted as humility. That time our hearts were nowhere to whatever we were doing. My friend, it is time to understand humility is not just physical. It is not just, well, I don't say that being soft-spoken is not humility, but it's not just being, slow speaking. No, it is humility is the state of the heart. When our heart is humble before the Lord sees it, and the Lord will lift us up. Bwana, as if you were sana, continually remaining at the position of dominion will require humility. Finally, brethren, I'll say this. Matthew chapter 6 and verse 33. Seek first his kingdom. Seek the kingdom of God, his righteousness. All these other things, they shall come. Position of your dominion socially. When you relate with the people so well, and you are enjoying the fellowship and the relationship, it shall follow. Seek first the kingdom of God. God will connect you socially. That will be the position of your dominion. God will connect you economically. Amen. Seek first his kingdom. These things will follow. Money will keep running. You know, signs and wonders will keep following us when we believe in him, when we are seeking his kingdom first. Amen. Seek first his kingdom. Bwana asifiwe sana. Tafuta ufalme wa Bwana kwanza. Amen. Mengine yote yatafuata. Amen. Bwana asifiwe sana. Even in your walk with the Lord, let us seek his kingdom. And then you keep us at the position of continuous dominion. Position of continuous dominion in the spirit of the Lord. Bwana asifiwe sana. When we seek his kingdom, the rest of the things will follow. Glory to the living God. Amen. As we come to a close, my friends, I'm here to address us and to say, a time has come to understand that this peace that we have been having in our home has been a moment that we can look at our lives and say, where am I in the dominion mandate? The Lord wants me to have a position of dominion, but where am I in the dominion mandate that the Father wants me to take? Praise the Lord. And when you look at it like that, when we get back to fellowshipping with brethren out there at our workplace, the position of your dominion will be evident. Amen. Autajipeleka, you not push yourself. The Lord himself has already positioned you. We have an opportunity. Between now and the moment that we have been declared to get back to gathering out there, to go back to kind of the, to do with the new normal, I'm here to announce to us, the Lord would want us to first identify that position of our dominion and then to hold dear the pillars that he is using of our dominion. Bwana asifiwe sana. Amen. When we do that, we'll have stability at that position of our dominion. Glory to the living God. I come to a close with a final statement that I'll tell you this. It is the Father's will. It is the Father's will to keep us upheld at the position of dominion. Why do I say this confidently? Isaiah chapter 41 and verse 10. That's what I'll finish with. You know, and I would want us to read that as we come to a praying moment. That we take up the position of our dominion. Amen. Isaiah chapter 41 and verse 10. The Bible speaks something very that I like always. That he desires that we learn that the position of our dominion, it is not for people who are afraid. Don't fear anything. Just hold unto the Lord and see what he says. Fear thou not, for I am with thee. Declare today, I will not fear. The Lord is with me. I will not be dismayed. Amen. Fear thou not, for I am with thee. Be not dismayed, for I am thy God. I will strengthen thee. Yeah. I will help thee. Yeah. I will uphold thee with the right hand of my righteousness. Praise the Lord. Amen. The Father is willing to uphold us with the right hand of his righteousness. And this is for you and for us, so that we be a people that are manifesting the position of our dominion. Bwana asipiwe sana. When you are a person that has taken up the position of your dominion, expect to see fruitfulness. Expect to see yourself subdue the earth. Expect to see yourself being at that point of your dominion where you are there and for sure you know very well you are doing what the Father sent you to do. Glory to the Almighty God. I know this message has blessed us. And maybe you are there. You are saying, how do I get to the position of my dominion? No other linkage to the position of dominion except through Jesus Christ. There is no other way except by believing Jesus Christ in your heart. If you do not know Jesus Christ and you want to take up your position of dominion while we are on the face of the earth, it is of importance that you turn to Jesus, receive him, acknowledge him as Lord and Savior, accept him as the supreme authority given by the Father of our lives, that he came and died for our sins so that we be lifted back to the position of dominion. Are you there? You do not know Jesus Christ? It's a time to say, Lord Jesus, have mercy on me, forgive me, and make me your very own from this moment henceforth. Believe him, walk with him, turn back to him if you had fallen off from the path of righteousness, and start to say, Jesus, have mercy on me. Why? The Father wants us to be at the position of dominion. So today what we have been looking at, friends, it has been about what pillars will hold us and sustain us at the position of dominion. Praise be to the Lord. And I know so well that the Father will cause us to continue meditating more and more on His Word, more and more on what He is saying, more and more on the things that you continue to reveal to us, even after this service. I know the Father will continue to speak to our hearts. Amen. It's my prayer that every one of us will be at that point where you say, for sure, I've been sustained at the position of my dominion. Thank you very much for watching. Once again, I want to appreciate you for choosing to be with us this day. Thank you very much. The Lord continually do you good. May you continue to enjoy the dominion mandate that the Lord has given us in Jesus' mighty name, for it was paid for by the Lord Himself. Let us make a prayer as we close. Our Father and our God, we are grateful. We are grateful that you love us so much, that you bring to us this word of reminding us the position, dear Father, that you want us to remain at. Thank you, Father, because it's your desire, it is your will, that, dear Father, we continually remain to dominate. We be a people who take dominion, Father, the positioning that you gave us. Thank you so much for giving Jesus Christ, for he died for us and purchased for us back to where we had lost, my Father, the position of dominion. And now, Father, I thank you for every listener who has paid attention, Lord, to hear what you are saying, that, Lord, over the period that we are in, oh God, you want us to continually remain at the position of dominion. I pray for the listener, I pray for myself, I pray for all of us in the name of Jesus Christ, that from this moment henceforth, we shall be a people that will be fruitful in the season that we are in the name of Jesus Christ. We will be a people that will manifest what taking dominion is all about for your glory. May we glorify you, precious Lord, by taking rightfully the possession of dominion that which you gave us, Abba Father, in every sphere of our lives, in the name of Jesus Christ. Father, we thank you, we glorify your name, because when, my Father, you are exalted through our lives, Lord, it's for your praise. And again, dear Lord, many more will come to the knowledge of who you are. We thank you because today, Lord, you help us to meditate on what it means to be a humble Lord that will be having humility. You remind us by your Spirit, Holy God. You also continually, Lord, help us to remember what you used, dear Lord, whatever channel you used to take us up to the possession of dominion, Lord, for your glory, precious Lord. You help us to trust in you, God, in the name of Jesus Christ. You also help us, O Lord, to forever remember to seek your kingdom, Lord. And I know all these things will follow where we seek your kingdom, precious Lord. We therefore thank you. We adore you. We bow before you. We magnify you, Lord. And we appreciate you because of who you are. Thank you so much, O God. We shall never leave the way of faith, the walk with you, O God. We shall remain forever abiding in you and your word in us. And so we shall bear fruit that will last at the position of dominion. Thank you, Holy God. I speak blessing unto every of the listeners. I prophesy and declare upon them a people that are elevated in this season, in the name of Jesus, to taking up their dominion mandate. In the name of Jesus, I speak unto every heart, my Father. I speak to everyone, my Father, listening and believing this word. Let it be, dear Lord, that the power of elevation will work for each one of us, Almighty God, that we take up that dominion mandate, the position, my Father, that you predetermined way before ages, Almighty God, that we will thrive at that position of dominion for your glory. None is being left behind, because every one of us is rising up to the position of dominion. We thank you and we glorify you, for this is so, and this word is sealed with the blood of Jesus. It is established for you, Father, to watch over it, that it will be perfected even in our very lives for your glory. And we thank you in advance. In Jesus' mighty name we pray and together believe. Amen. The Lord bless you. Thank you for your patience that we took 10 minutes late, and so we have extended by 10 minutes. Thank you. God bless you. Keep on sharing this message. We'll meet again next Sunday, same time, at 9:30 to 11:30, as the Lord will enable us. Amen. God bless you, and I love you.